And welcome back inside Strand Arena. Texas State on top, 29-27 at the half. We now have the pleasure of being joined by new head football coach Jake Spavital. Coach, I'm sure you've heard this a few times by now, but again, welcome to Texas State. Welcome to San Marcos. You look at your career, so much success as an offensive coordinator in several P5 programs. When the decision for you came to become a head coach, why did you ultimately choose Texas State?
There's a lot of things. You know, first off, I think we're in one of the largest recruiting hotbeds in the country, and just the familiarity that I have with Texas, I know that you can get a quality player to come to Texas State. But there's so many things that you can sell with this university, just from the student population of 40,000 people and being in probably what I consider one of the greatest areas to live in the country. There's just so many things that you can sell. But the thing that kind of put it over the top was the commitment that they have to the football program. And this university and this administration, they want a winner, and they're willing to give the support needed to have success here.
Now, Bobcat fans did get a little nervous a few weeks ago when the rumors about perhaps you going to the NFL came about, but you're able to quiet those rumors with one simple tweet through social media.
Yeah, you know, that's where the NFL is going right now. They're going to a lot of college-based offenses just for the immediate success of the college quarterback to translate into the NFL system. So, you know, I'm very fortunate, very lucky to be around some good coaches, and I had some great opportunities to move to the next level in the NFL. But I truly believe in this place. I think we can do something special here, and I'm enjoying my time as a Bobcat.
You mentioned being around some great coaches. The first two coaches you hired, Zach Spavital, your brother, as defensive coordinator, Bob Stitt as the offensive coordinator. Now you have a complete staff as a whole. Take us through the coaching staff and how you put this together.
Yeah, so I started off with my brother. You know, he's been the hardest one to keep on the staff because he's a wanted coach. He's been recruiting this state of Texas for a long time, and he's very good at what he does. And I've watched him build defenses and done a great job and gone up to against him a lot of times. And, you know, that was just a great gift for us. And then when you get with Bob Stitt, who he brings the wealth of knowledge and the experience and the innovation as an offensive play caller and as a head coach. He was a head coach for 18 years, seen a lot of different things, and he can help me out from an experience standpoint. But you know, we retained Ron Antoine, who I've known for a long time, and, you know, there is a good connection here at Texas State with his wife being the head basketball coach. But, you know, he's done an exceptional job in recruiting, and I've crossed paths with him many times, and I'm fired up for Ron. But got the opportunity to bring Morris Berger in, a young coach on offense who's going to coach our tight ends. Mm-hmm. Probably the most persistent coach I've been around, who I'm very excited for, and he's been doing an exceptional job already in recruiting. So. Very, very fortunate to have some of these guys, and I know he's thankful for the opportunity to be here. But you look at it from a defensive side, let me finish with our O-line coach, Clay McGuire, who is a huge get here, who was Mike Leach's offensive line coach at Washington State for a long time. He was at Texas Tech last year. You know, a quality coach, recruited West Texas better than the best, you know, and we're excited to have him on the offensive side of the ball. When you wrap up the defensive side of the ball, we get Tremaine Jackson, who is a defense coordinator at Abilene Christian, who, you know, that alone, he was very respected in this profession, and he's called it. And he took a title cut just to come and be a part of the D-line and just share the vision of what we got here, which we're fortunate to have these guys because they're quality coaches. Now we got to hold on to them, of course. But you get to Archie McDaniel, who played at Texas A&M. You know, he's got some deep Texas ties, you know, and he's been at SMU to New Mexico, and he's going to coach our inside linebackers, and he's our co-defensive coordinator. So, again, you know, we're lucky to have him. And when you get to our last coach, it's Tevin Mims. Tevin Mims is a guy that played at University of Texas. He's right down the street in Austin. It's his first coaching opportunity, but I have all the faith in him that he's going to do a great job for us.
Well, Coach, we're excited to have you here at Texas State. Welcome once again to San Marcos. Looking forward to football season coming up.
Awesome. I can't wait.
All right. That again, our visit with Jake Spavital. More halftime coverage coming up on ESPN+.